गुड मॉर्निंग मा. यस्टरडे इन द लास्ट क्लास वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट एम्प्लॉयमेंट
द वर्किंग लाइफ इन इंडिया
वर्किंग लाइफ इन इंडिया यस
इंडिया
यस. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल I would like to ask some questions regarding what we learnt in the last classes. First of all, what are the important sectors of Indian economy?
Three sectors, sir.
Primary, secondary, tributary sector. Tertiary. Agriculture sector, industrial sector, and service sector.
Service sector.
Very good. Next one. Next question is, what is the definition of GDP?
Gross domestic product.
Expansion of GDP, not abbreviation of GDP. What is GDP? Definition. Total number of goods and
within our nation.
This is called GDP.
GDP.
What is the today's GDP? I think it may minus 25. 24, 25, minus. First time occurred in the world history. You know what is the reason behind it?
Due to the pandemic situation, there is no employment.
Pandemic situation of corona.
Things are going, sir.
Yes. Yes, what is the reason fall of the growth rate due to corona? Corona is a disease.
There is no employment.
Is there any relation?
Sir, buying people are not there, sir.
Emma? Once again.
Buying and selling process is not going, sir.
Yes, buying and selling. It is related one. Unemployment one. First one, unemployment. There is no scope for open the factories, produce the goods, and provide the services. Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
So many doctors who are the soldiers during this time, they also fall ill due to corona. And yesterday, I think all of you seen in the newspapers and the televisions, our Tirupati MP died due to corona.
Yes, sir.
30 members in the parliament faced the problem with corona. See, this is the situation. So, during this time, there is no scope for open the factories, open the schools, not scope for provide services like doctors, lawyers, etc. So this is the situation about services. What about the production? Factories closed. The workers who are working the factories, they lost their employment. They lost their purchasing capacity due to no wages. So this is the situation during the time of. So automatically what Pushpalata I think she said, selling and buying process stopped. Entire selling and buying, consumers not going to buy any good. They are afraiding. They are not going out, isn't it? So this is the situation. In these situations, the people are afraid and they are not doing any common activities. See, day-to-day life, entire life, our life, based on the consuming and selling, consuming. మనం ప్రతిరోజు దినచర్యలో మనం ఏదైనా వస్తువు కొనడం, ప్రతి వస్తువును వాడడం, ఇవన్నీ చూస్తుంటాం మనం నిజ జీవితంలో ప్రతిరోజు. ఉదాహరణ, ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ షుగర్, ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ మిల్క్, టీ పౌడర్, రైస్, వీట్, ఇజంట్ ఇట్ టు ఈట్. అండ్ నాట్ ఓన్లీ టు ఈట్, టు కన్స్ట్రక్ట్ ఎ హౌస్, సో మెనీ, వాట్ ఆర్ ద ఇంపార్టెంట్ ఆర్టికల్స్ వీ నీడ్ టు బై టు construct a house?
Cement, concrete.
Cement.
Yes, cement. Bricks.
Yes.
And
people,
sir. Remain in
things. Furniture, sir.
No, sand.
Labor, sir.
Sand. Isn't it iron? Wood. Isn't it?
Yes.
Not only these things, but also the workers who construct the house. So these are all important things to complete a work. So why I am asking these things? During the time of corona, we can't go for buy all these things, and they can't produce all these things. All these were stopped during this time. So this pandemic situation has created -24 GDP within India. Not only India, overall all the nations facing this problem today. Now come back to the lesson. See this slide, all of you. Look at this slide. Who is he? Do you know? Who is he? Andar kanipistunnama?
Shaktikant Das.
Who is he? Kanipistunnama andarki clear ga?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Do you know about him? He is governor of RBI. All of you note down in your notebooks. RBI, expansion of RBI, Reserve Bank of India, Bankers Bank. What are the banks, do you know? Name some of the banks.
SBI,
State Bank of India.
SBI, State Bank of India. Canara Bank.
Andhra Bank.
Isn't it? Andhra Bank.
Gramin Bank.
Andhra, Gramin Bank. So these are all so many banks. Or to all these banks, one bank is superior, that is RBI. Under the guidelines of RBI, all these banks work. Here is the governor, present governor of RBI, Sri Shaktikant Das. Why I am telling all these things? Elias.
Hello, PPT presenter.
పెట్టినావు లేదు, అదే అది ఓపెన్, అది ఆల్రెడీ నేను ఓపెన్ చేయలేదు, అందుకని దీన్నే చూపిస్తున్నా. అదే ఓపెన్ చేస్తాను, 1 మినిట్, అదే ఓపెన్ చేస్తున్నా. డౌన్లోడ్ అయింది. ఎస్, వై ఐఎమ్ టెలింగ్ అబౌట్ ఆర్బిఐ, బికాస్ దే మానిటర్ ద ఇంట్రెస్ట్ రేట్ అండ్ ఆల్ ద ఇంట్రెస్ట్ రేట్, repo rate, all these things monitored by the RBI, Reserve Bank of India. Now, Reserve Bank, what is the symbol of the RBI? This is the symbol of RBI, Reserve Bank of India. See, this is the building of RBI. It is located in Mumbai. అందరికి సరిగా కనిపిస్తుందమ్మా? ఇస్ ఇట్ విజిబుల్ టు ఆల్?
Yes,
it is located in Mumbai. Financial capital of India is Mumbai. Capital of India is administrative capital?
New Delhi.
Administrative capital?
Delhi.
India. India's administrative capital is?
New Delhi.
Delhi. Now, look at this. First of all, I would like to tell about the disguised unemployment. What is disguised unemployment? Disguised unemployment means there are more people in agriculture but may not be fully occupied because see, this is the, see, once take once look at this picture. The GDP actual today is -23.9, nearly 24. Previously it was 3.1, highest 11.4. Two digits GDP also was there once, but today the GDP is -23.9. All of you note down all these things. Next one is disguised unemployment. See, there are more people in agriculture but may not be able to fully be occupied. Even few people move out, production will be not affected. It is called underemployment. Underemployment means chudanamma andaru 10 mandi oka kutumbamlo unnaru 100 mootalu panta pandincharu iddaru auto thalladaniki ఇంకా ఇద్దరు వేరే పని చేయడానికి బ్రిక్స్ మేకింగ్ ఆఫ్ బ్రిక్స్ ఇలా రకరకాల పనులకు వెళ్ళినప్పుడు 6 మంది మళ్ళీ అదే 100 మూటల్ని ఉత్పత్తి చేశారు. ఐ థింక్ యూ అండర్స్టాండ్ వాట్ ఐ సెడ్. ఇన్ ద రూరల్ ఏరియాస్ ఇట్ ఈస్ వెరీ క్వైట్ కామన్. సంబడి వెంట్ టు క్వైట్ దుబాయ్ యుఏఈ అండ్ ఆల్ అండ్ రీమెయిన్ ద ప్రొడక్షన్ ఈస్ సేమ్. ప్రొడక్షన్ ఈస్ సేమ్. దిస్ ఈస్ ద సిచ్యువేషన్ in the real life. I think you all of you observed nearby your house, and in your house there is no change in production. Few people came out from the production activity. Na artham avutundha ma andarki?
Yes,
this is called underemployment. This is also called, one more new word added, what it is? Disguised unemployment. Disguised unemployment. All of you note down what is disguised unemployment. D-I-S-G-U-I-S-E-D. Disguised unemployment. Small farmer Gayatri, they given in the textbook example, 2 hectares land, depending on rainfall, 5 members in their house, work in their flat, and they produce the crop rice. No one is fully employed. 2 members go for drive auto, or for work searching in the outside of our nation, abroad. But the production is same. This is the situation. In this situation, this is underemployment. They are able to do work as their sufficient, what it is called, potential. Based on the potentiality, the work is not provided. 2 members go out from their family, but the production is same. This situation is called underemployment. Disguised unemployment. No change in the production. They go for other work, and income increased for their house, but the production is same. అర్థమైందమ్మా? ఇన్ దిస్ వే ఇన్ అదర్ సెక్టార్ ఆల్సో ద సేమ్ సిచ్యువేషన్ ఇస్ కామన్. ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ సర్వీస్ సెక్టార్, పెయింటర్స్, ప్లంబర్స్, దే డిడ్ నాట్ హ్యావ్ ఫైండ్ వర్క్. దే ఆర్ స్కిల్డ్ ఎంప్లాయీస్ అండ్ అన్స్కిల్డ్ ఎంప్లాయీస్. స్కిల్డ్ అండ్ ఎడ్యుకేటెడ్ వర్కర్స్ ఆర్ దేర్ ఇన్ సర్వీస్ సెక్టార్. ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ టీచర్స్, దే నీడ్ సమ్ స్కిల్, దే నీడ్ సమ్ ట్రైనింగ్. They are called as skilled and educated employees, workers. Those who are not, need not training, certificate, painters, plumbers, and rickshaw pullers, shopkeepers, transport persons, all these persons unskilled labor. This is also try to learn with the help of pie chart. All of you look at the pie chart. See the screen. One second, ma. First pie chart. Look at the pie chart. Sectoral shares of employment. Look at the pie chart in 1970. Comparison between 1972 to 2009. There are three sectors. You know, sectoral shares. Vividha rangala nundi entha mandiki upadhi labhistundi. In 1972, what happened from agriculture sector?
74%.
74%.
Compare it,
74. In
2009?
53%,
sir. It is
53. What happened here? Reduced the employment in agriculture sector. That means shift takes place from agriculture sector to another sector. Now, industrial sector in 1972,
11%. 2009 is
22%,
sir. It is
increased. Double. Increase double. Compared to 1972. Shift takes place. Some of the workers from agriculture sector take shift to industrial sector.
Industrial
sector. We have to write like this statement. Third one, service sector.
Service sector.
Is
15% in 1972.
That means, what do you observe in this sectoral shares of employment? What do you observe?
Except agriculture, both sectors are increased, sir.
Both sectors are increased. Next one.
But agriculture sector decreased in percentage, sir.
Yes, next. Workers shifted here, isn't it? Finally, you can say that workers shifted from one sector to another sector. They search for better employment. Isn't it? They search for better employment. You know that in second pie diagram, look at this pie diagram, another pie diagram, shares of the sectors in GDP. Contribution of the sectoral shares to GDP. Contribution. ఏ రంగం నుండి ఎంత ఆదాయం వస్తుంది 1972 టు 2009 ఆఫ్టర్ 30 ఇయర్స్ వాట్ చేంజెస్ వర్ మేడ్ కాంట్రిబ్యూషన్ ఆఫ్ షేర్స్ ఆఫ్ ద డిఫరెంట్ సెక్టార్స్ టు జీడిపి కంపేర్ ఇట్ 40 టు 17 ఫాలో మీ 22 టు 26 35 టు
57
Isn't it? What happened here? Finally, conclusion.
The share of the sector in 1972 to 73 increased.
Depending on agriculture
sector. The shares of the service sector.
From agriculture sector, contribution of the agriculture sector fall down. And rapid growth contribution from service sector compared to 1972 to 2009. That means declined the contribution of agriculture sector to GDP. Very less portion. It is also an indicator decline the dependence on agriculture sector and improved the dependence on remaining industrial and service sector. Major portion contribution of service sector to GDP, you can find it in the pie diagram, isn't it? So shift of employment also takes place the contribution of shares of the sector to GDP. Ante ikkada కేవలం ఉపాధి ఒక రంగం నుండి ఒక రంగానికి మారడమే కాదు, వచ్చే ఆదాయం కూడా ఆయా రంగాల నుండి వచ్చే ఆదాయం కూడా మార్పు ఉంటుంది జీడిపిలో అనేది ఇక్కడ మనం గ్రహించాలి. సి 92% ఆఫ్ ద వర్కర్స్ ఆర్ అండర్ అన్ఆర్గనైజ్ సెక్టార్, 8% ఆఫ్ ద వర్కర్స్ ఆర్ అండర్ ఆర్గనైజ్ సెక్టార్, ఓన్లీ 8% ఈజ్ ఆర్గనైజ్ సెక్టార్. ఫస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ వాట్ అబౌట్ ఆర్గనైజ్ అండ్ అన్ఆర్గనైజ్ సెక్టార్ విత్ వన్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్, ఇట్ ఈస్ దేర్ ఇన్ ద టెక్స్ట్ బుక్, లుక్ అట్ ద టెక్స్ట్ బుక్, నరసింహ అండ్ రాజేశ్వరి విత్ సమ్ పిక్చర్స్. మా అందరూ ఓపెన్ చేశారమ్మా టెక్స్ట్ బుక్, టెక్స్ట్ బుక్. ఇన్ ద టెక్స్ట్ బుక్ యు కెన్ సీ నరసింహ. వాట్ అబౌట్ నరసింహ? ఈజ్ ఎ వర్కర్ ఫ్రమ్ 9:30 to 5:30, రెగ్యులర్ సాలరీ, పిఎఫ్, మెడికల్ అలవెన్సెస్, పెయిడ్ హాలిడే, పెయిడ్ ఇన్ హాలిడేస్, అపాయింట్మెంట్ లెటర్ బి గివెన్ అండ్ రూల్స్ అండ్ రెగ్యులేషన్స్ గివెన్ ఇన్ ద అపాయింట్మెంట్ లెటర్. బై బైక్ హీ వెంట్ టు ఆఫీస్ 5 kilometers. So this is about Narasimha. Simply I am explaining. Rajeshwari. What about Rajeshwari? She is a worker. From 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. That means nearly 12 hours work, working hours. By bus she go every day 10 kilometers. Lunch break only from 1 to 2. And get only work 10 to 12 days within the month. 150 rupees per day. Unseasonal days, she won't work from July to January. She is the member of self-help group. When she fall in an accident, no treatment was given. See, what were the conditions between the two persons? Is there same, is they are same or not? What is the difference? Yes, what is the difference?
Narasimha is a government office worker.
Yes, government employee, organized sector. What is organized? The rules were framed. Formal procedure was there. Appointment letter and prescribed rules and rules and regulations followed. Continuously 12 months salary. For example, in our school, part-time teachers, regular teachers. 12 months salary to regular teachers. There is no salary to part-time teachers. Isn't it? During the time of pandemic situation, corona, no salary was paid to part-time teachers. There is no work. There is no pay. So this is the situation. But to regular employees, opened their SR, service register, all the rules were given to them, and PF was there, medical allowance was there to the regular employees, appointment letter given, paid in holidays. There is security to the regular employees. Security. Minimum Wages Act, Factories Act, Shop and Establishment Act, formal process and procedure was there. So this is about organized sector. Now look at another slide. Organized sector are registered by the government, follow the rules and regulations. Security in the employment, only fixed working hours, and they paid in leaves, even payment during holidays, provident fund, PF. So job security, these are all the benefits to the regular employees. Even they retire after from the services, they provide pension to their family. Look at this picture. What do you observe in this picture? What is this activity? Raise your hand, Ilyas will give opportunity. Basket making. Yes. Next one. Brick making. Bricks. Isn't it? అంటున్నారమ్మా బ్రిక్స్ మేక్. నెక్స్ట్ వన్ హియర్ అనదర్ పిక్చర్ వాట్ ఈస్ హియర్ ఎస్ దిస్ ఈస్ హౌస్ కన్స్ట్రక్షన్ కన్స్ట్రక్షన్ ఆఫ్ ఎ కెనాల్ ఇజంట్ ఇట్
ఎస్
నెక్స్ట్ పిక్చర్ హియర్ ఆల్సో హౌస్ కన్స్ట్రక్షన్ ఎస్ వాట్ డూ యూ అబ్జర్వ్ ఇన్ దిస్ పిక్చర్ Speak of something. Yes, service sector. They are in front of computers, telecommunications, or software employees in some companies, isn't it? They are organized sector. Some unions are formed. And company form business rules, organized sector, companies, government employees, they are all comes under organized. Unorganized sector, there is no rules and regulations and not paid for fair wages, exploited, low salary, no pension. You have to write all these things. Paid leaves were there, paid in during the holidays, లీవ్ డ్యూ టు సిక్నెస్ ఏదైనా అనారోగ్యం అయితే హాస్పిటల్కి వెళ్తే ఈహెచ్ఎస్ ఎంప్లాయ్మెంట్ హెల్త్ స్కీమ్ ఇన్ క్యాపిటల్స్ దే రిటర్న్ ఈహెచ్ఎస్ గవర్నమెంట్ విల్ పే ఇఫ్ యూ టేక్ ట్రీట్మెంట్ ఇన్ ద హాస్పిటల్స్ ఈవెన్ ఇన్ ప్రైవేట్ హాస్పిటల్స్ గవర్నమెంట్ విల్ పే ఇఫ్ యూ ఫాల్ సిక్నెస్ నో సెక్యూర్ నాట్ సెక్యూర్ ఇన్ ద అనార్గనైజ్ సెక్టార్ ఇఫ్ యూ ఆస్క్ టు లీవ్ they ask to leave without any notice, without any reason. See, these are all common in selling in the streets, hawkers, repair as workers, all these things, all these people, they are comes under unorganized sector.
Okay,
given here, what is the comparison between organized and unorganized sector? All of you note down all these things. Is there in the textbook fixed working hours? No fixed working hours. Not paid in holidays, paid in holidays. Like this, we have to note on all this in negative manner. Medical benefits, there were no benefits for unorganized workers. So how many people were there under unorganized sector? 92%. How many people were there under organized sector? Only 8%. So much of percentage of people fall under unorganized sector. They face so many problems. In the villages, who comes under unorganized sector? Landless agricultural laborers, small and marginal farmers, sharecroppers, artisans, beavers, blacksmiths, carpenters, goldsmiths. 80% of the people were in villages were organized,
unorganized sector.
Here another slide is there. What is it? NREGA. NREGA in Telugu. NREGA. National Rural Employment Guarantee
Act.
Actually, it is Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment. Yes, Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment. Mahatma Gandhi, ayana peru pettaru anamata. Recently, 200 districts of India provided work to the poor people. Manam intha munchu cheptunnam Gayatri ane ammayi ledha inkoka Narasimha tho compare chesina రాజేశ్వరిని మహిళ కేవలం 10-12 రోజులు మాత్రమే ఉపాధి అంటే సంవత్సరానికి ఎన్ని రోజులు 120 రోజులు ఓన్లీ 120 డేస్ వాట్ అబౌట్ రిమైనింగ్ 245 డేస్ ఇమాజిన్ దట్ వితౌట్ వర్క్ హౌ దేర్ లైఫ్ లివింగ్ స్టాండర్డ్ ఆఫ్ ద పీపుల్ వెరీ పూర్ సో గవర్నమెంట్ ఆఫ్ ఇండియా టేకన్ అప్ ఏ స్టెప్ and started a program NREGA Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Scheme. Under this scheme, 100 days within 1 year, 100 days work should be provided to the laborers who are unemployed. This is the NREGA. ఇది ఏమవుతుందంటే అందరికి ఉపాధి కల్పించడం వల్ల ఎక్కువ రోజులు వాళ్ళకి ఈ కన్జంప్షన్ కెపాసిటీ కన్స్యూమింగ్ కెపాసిటీ పెరుగుతుంది అన్నమాట. అంటే వాళ్ళకి పర్చేసింగ్ కెపాసిటీ పెరుగుతుంది, వాళ్ళు ఏ వస్తువు కావాలన్నా కొనగలిగే కొంత సామర్థ్యం వాళ్ళకి అనేది పెరుగుతుంది. ఇది ఆర్థికంగా కూడా ఒక బూస్ట్ లాగా అనమాట మార్కెట్, మన ఇండియన్ మార్కెట్ ఎక్కువ మందికి ఉపాధి కల్పించడం ప్రభుత్వం యొక్క విధి. కాన్స్టిట్యూషన్ ప్రకారం అందరికీ పని కల్పించాలి అనేది కూడా ఒక హక్కు అనమాట, అందరి యొక్క హక్కు. దానిలో భాగంగా ప్రభుత్వం అనేక కార్యక్రమాలు ప్రవేశపెడుతుంటుంది. సి దిస్ ఈస్ అబౌట్ ఆర్గనైజ్ సెక్టార్ అండ్ అన్ఆర్గనైజ్ సెక్టార్. ఎస్ ఎనీ వన్ డూ యూ హ్యావ్ ఎనీ డౌట్ ఇన్ విత్ ఇన్ దిస్ ఆర్గనైజ్ సెక్టార్ అండ్ అన్ఆర్గనైజ్ సెక్టార్? Do you have any doubt regarding it?
No, sir.
If you understand well, what is organized sector? With the example nearby your house, nearby your village, what is organized sector? With one example, live example, with their names, what were their situations in their real life? Don't take more time.
So organized sector.
With one your live example from your village. అంటే మీ గ్రామంలో జరుగుతున్న దాన్ని ఉదాహరణగా.
Okay. So organized sector.
చందన చెప్పుమ్మా.
Sir. మా ఇంటి పక్కన ఒక అంకుల్ ఉంటారు సార్, అతను ఒక పోలీస్.
స్పీక్ ఇన్ ఇంగ్లీష్, ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ పాసిబుల్ దెన్ యు స్పీక్ ఇన్ తెలుగు, నో ప్రాబ్లం. విత్
మై నవర్ హౌస్ వన్ అంకుల్ షీస్ వర్కింగ్ పోలీస్ స్టేషన్ ఇస్ ద హెడ్ కానిస్టేబుల్. హీ డైలీ గో 9:30 అండ్ రిటర్న్ night 1 o'clock or 2 o'clock. He is servicing at
yes, that means they may have one day half. They go to police station up to 1 o'clock midnight, means another day, the next day half. They need not go to police station next day. But even compared to unorganized sector, continuously work from 7 morning 7 a.m. to night 7 a.m. Rajeshwari, there is no half to Rajeshwari, isn't it? That is the difference.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Chandana, what do you want to say? Conclude it. I think they are well in their house with sufficient mixie, washing machine, fridge.
Yes.
Isn't it? Their life is very, yes, well, I think. Isn't it? Their children go to private schools and they are well educated. Yes. Isn't it? Pakka house, yes. Permanent house. Yes, very good. Next, chance to Puspalata.
Puspalata. So first, organized sector means... Organized sector is normally governed by the government with some restrictions and rules, sir. And
I am asking
in my village.
Example. Yes.
In my village, Raju sir is one of the government employee. He is a teacher in government school, sir. And he is well with good sufficient money and with economic. Wealth, sir.
Yes,
and
very good.
He is running privately one school also, sir.
Yes, that means she is capable to run another school, even a school. It is not a, isn't it, easy task. Yes, one example, unorganized sector from villages. So many students are in this class are from villages. Unorganized employee, worker.
Sir, can I say?
Ah, yes, yes. Mosmita.
Sir, nearby my house, one lady, sir, her name is Suma. She done work for daily wages, sir. She have worked for only 15 days per month. And she paid less salary, sir. But she works from morning 7 a.m. to evening 6, sir. But she has less wages, sir.
Less wages.
But there is no...
When the accident takes place, fall, illness, sickness, what about the situation of her family?
She is not economically good, sir. And she is the woman who leads the family, sir.
Yes, government may provide a pakka house to her, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
She is not able to construct a house with her own. So this is the situation of unorganized sector. Any another example from another student from unorganized sector? You can change the name of the people.